Why are you doing that?
You see, I want the particles in my food to vibrate at just the right frequency.
Wait, you forgot to make that one vibrate.
Oh, well, see, not with this food. This one's already vibrating at the desired frequency, but if it starts to vibrate at a higher frequency, I lock it back in the cold box.
All our teeth fall out as children, and they all grow back stronger.
Okay, I mean, that definitely sounds fake, but okay.
We have smaller secret pants that we wear under our normal pants.
Why?
Imagine being a human in an alien crew in space and leaving with bright blue or pink hair, and the color fades and everybody on board wonders,
why are you losing your colors? Is it the lack of greens? Are you sad? Angry? They just don't know! Human biology is baffling!
These are the kind of pure posts I come to this place for.
I'm sorry. What? Did you just say your comfortable temperature range is?
Honestly, we can tolerate anywhere from negative 40 to 50 Celsius, but we prefer to zero the 30 range.
I'm sorry, did you just list temperatures below freezing?
Yeah, but most of us prefer to throw on scarves or jackets at those temperatures. It can be a bit nippy.
Nah, mate, I knew this guy in college who refused to wear anything past his knees and elbows until it was like negative 20 at least.
Yeah, everybody knows someone like that.
And did you also say 50 Celsius, as in halfway to boiling?
Ugh, yes, it sucks. We sweat everywhere, and God help you if you touch a seatbelt buckle. But yes.
We've got like 50 uninhabitable planets we think you might enjoy. You're telling me that you have settlements on islands with active volcanism?
Well, yeah. I'm not about to tell Iceland and Hawaii how to live their lives. Actually, it's kind of a tourist attraction.
What, the molten rock?
Well, yeah. It's not every day you see a mountain spew out liquid rocks. The best one's in Yellowstone, though. All those hot springs and geysers from the supervolcano.
You actively seek out active supervolcanoes.
Shit, man, we swim in the groundwater near them.
But surely you have records of volcanic activity doing tremendous damage to human settlements.
Yep, Pompeii's legendary. Entire cities went, towns buried under lava, people's brains boiled in the first rush of heat. Loads more killed by falling pumice.
Ah, good. They learned their lesson and didn't build there again.
Well...
Are you seriously telling me this volcano is legendary for killing several urban conurbations and you built on top of it again?
In our defense, it actually hasn't done it since.
What about earthquake-prone areas? Tell me you're at least vaguely sensible about those.
Oh yeah, after the first major earthquake that flattens a city, we build them better.
And you say the poles of your world would get as low as negative 100 with wind chill?
Yep, with blizzards you can't see through every other day just about.
Amazing. When did you manage to send drones that would survive such temperatures?
Well, actually...
What?
We kind of sent people.
What?
We sent...
No, I heard you. Did I just... What? You sent humans to a place 100 degrees below freezing?
Yeah.
And they didn't die?
Well, the first few did.
People died of the cold, and your solution was to send more people? That's it. I'm off this planet. Y'all are fucking crazy.